There's something about the monsoons. The grey clouds, the pitter-patter of raindrops, and the chill in the air. The plants have been painted lush green by the water, and the roads washed to an inky black. The perfect weather to explore, to go for a drive.
Hello and welcome to Evo India, and welcome to yet another episode of our Great Driving Road series. This time we're at the Tamani Ghat and we have with us here the Hyundai Creta, so expect some stunning views ahead. But before that, like this video, leave a comment below on where you think we should go next, and do subscribe to the Evo India YouTube channel.
Now, the roads leading up to the Tamani Ghat aren't too great, and you will probably need an SUV like the Hyundai Creta to get there. Even so, it takes just under 2 hours to get to the Tamani Ghat from our home base in Pune.
Now, the Tamani Ghat is actually lovely. The road is inky black, smooth flowing corners, nothing too dangerous, and the views, they are incredible. You can get a good look at the hills on your left side. On the right side, behind me, through the trees, you can just get a peek at the river flowing parallelly along the road. It is a lovely sight to see, and if it wasn't soaking wet, we'd be stopping plenty of times to get some pictures in. Another advantage of the Tamani Ghat being a popular tourist destination is the fact that there's plenty of eateries and even places to stay all around. So you could even come just for a Sunday drive or even stay and spend the weekend over here. As you climb up the Tamani Ghat, there are plenty of places that you can trek into. There are lots of trails going through the hills. And as you get to the top, the views are absolutely spectacular. Today is an exceptionally cloudy and foggy day, so we don't expect the views to be too great. So we might not be making the effort of that hike. But when it is a clear day, the views are something to behold. Now, in terms of connectivity, the Tamani Ghat is actually not too far away from Lavasa. You almost come all the way to Lavasa, but instead of turning left and heading towards there, you head straight and come towards the Tamani Ghat. So the road isn't too hard to find, and it doesn't even take too long from the heart of the city. Just under 2 hours, depending on the traffic conditions and where you live. The Creta is an absolute joy to drive at the Tamani Ghat. Because of the flowing corners, you can really chuck it into bends. There's enough line of sight ahead. There's no real blind turns here. So it's not particularly dangerous to carry some extra speed into corners. Although we do always suggest driving at 8/10 of your abilities versus at the full max. And of course, don't treat this as your own personal racetrack. This is of course a public road, but you know, at the end of the day, you should have fun in some safety. Now, speaking of safety, it is here where the electronic stability control, traction control and the ABS of the Creta really come into play, especially on a soaking wet day like this. Now, without these systems, you would have to be a little cautious when driving through such treacherous weather. But with these systems turned on, the Creta is absolutely sure-footed. You can brake hard into corners, the wheels don't lock up, and the ABS system is not very intrusive. The traction control and the electronic stability control, they keep you in check and don't throw the car offline too much. The Creta that we took along with us is the 1.5-litre diesel with the 6-speed manual, and I must tell you, it is an absolute joy for these roads. There's enough lower-end torque that you're not left struggling coming out of corners, but when you do a rev match downshift and throw the car into a corner, it is plenty of fun to throw around. And even on a long swooping corner that we've just taken now, you can carry plenty of speed. There is a bit of body roll, but in turn, the Creta sort of flattens any unsettlements, any undulations that you might find mid-corner, which makes the road actually feel more supple, more uniform than it actually is. Of course, another advantage of the Creta is the fact that while the approach road is bad, it is absolutely no problem for the Creta. It has enough ground clearance to clear all of those potholes without breaking a sweat, and you can even head into one of the trails leading down to either the lake or heading up towards the hills in and around Tamani Ghat. At just under 2 hours from the heart of the city, the Tamani Ghat is a great weekend getaway for anyone living in Pune. And if you live in Mumbai, don't feel left out, because getting here takes just over 3 hours. There's a lot to see here, and with something like the Hyundai Creta at your disposal, there's also a lot to explore. Now, another thing that the Tamani Ghat is famous for are haunted stories.